The Application Builder allows you to develop both internal and public web-based applications on top of your Baserow database or other data sources. This video focuses on master detail pages. A master detail page is a user interface pattern commonly used in web applications with a relational structure between data elements. The master page shows an overview of items such as contacts, products, or any kind of data. The detail page shows detailed information about the item that was selected in the master page. In this chapter, you will learn how to pass parameters to the detail page, fetch a single item based on a parameter, show the data in various user interface elements, and navigating from the master to the detail page. The home page already provides an overview of scheduled events. This page has two data sources, each returning a list of rows. The data is sourced from the view of the Schedules table within the Event Staffing database. This page serves as the master page. Let's create a second page for the details. Click the Create Page button and name the page Event Details. Each page is assigned a unique path, which is added to the URL for navigation. By default, the path mirrors the page name without spaces or special characters. A detail page requires a parameter to dynamically fetch a single row based on that provided parameter. Append a parameter to the path by adding a colon followed by a name. While any name is acceptable, ID is the most suitable choice here since it is the ID that will be passed to the page. The next step is creating a data source for the details page. Offers this data source a descriptive name such as event details. Unlike the data sources on the master page, this data source returns a single row. The data comes from a local Baserow database within the same workspace, which is the Event Staffing database and the Schedules table, just like on the master page. The final field to complete is the row ID. In Baserow, each row is automatically assigned a unique ID upon creation. This can be checked within the database, for instance, the Schedules table currently has 16 records with the IDs ranging from 1 to 16. A new record will receive the next available ID. Note that IDs are never reused. Let's go back to the data source. A parameter was defined for the detail page to hold the ID of the record. Assign this parameter to the row ID. Test the data source by adding a new header element to the page. This element will show the title of the selected event. Click the text field of the header to find the event details data source, containing all fields from the Schedules table. Directly selecting the name of the event isn't possible, because the event field is a linked field. Linked fields are always presented as a list of items, even if only one item exists. Instead, choose the first item and display its respective value. The header element now shows the name of the event with ID number 1, thanks to the Application Builder supporting live previews of dynamic data. Adjusting the previewed ID at the top of the page instantly updates the displayed information on that page. Let's complete the detail page with additional user interface elements. Note that a single element, such as a header or text field, can contain multiple fields from the data source and be supplemented with hard-coded text. Using a container with 3 or more columns for UI elements ensures the application responsiveness, with columns arranged in a row on a desktop and stacked on top of each other in a smartphone view. Finally, observe the use of the iframe element. An iframe facilitates the integration of external content into the website, such as a weather widget in this case. The city or location for the widget is dynamic since it depends on the geo-object field from the database. The final step is linking the master page with the detail page. Return to the home page that serves as the master page and select the table. The last column is a link button intended to navigate to the details page. Select the event details page, and because this page requires a parameter, indicate the source of this parameter's value. In almost all scenarios, this will be the ID of the selected item in the table. Now, proceed to test the application in preview mode. Click the Preview button in the upper right corner. Select an event to view all its details. Return to the home page and select a different event. The data on the Details page consistently adjusts according to the selected item. Master detail pages play a crucial role in web application development, offering users a streamlined interface for navigating and accessing detailed information within datasets. By employing this user interface pattern, applications present a high-level overview of data elements while allowing users to delve into specific details. This user interface pattern is based on passing parameters to detail pages, fetching a single item based on that parameter, displaying data using various UI elements, and establishing navigation between master and detail pages.